titanium plus 3 with D1 configuration, vanadium plus 3 with D2 configuration, chromium plus 3 with D3 configuration. That means one number of electron d orbital present in d orbital, two electrons present in d orbital in case of vanadium plus 3, three unpaired electrons are present in case of chromium plus 3. While they are going to form metal complexes with ligands, there is definitely presence of vacant d orbital. That means no need of pairing of electrons in these three cases. So hence, before the formation of metal complex and after the formation of metal complex, the easy availability of d orbital, which indicates the nature of magnetic character, remains unchanged. Whatever the magnetic character executed by these three ions, the similar manner of magnetic behavior identified when these metal ions forms coordination complexes. Whereas in case of D4, D5, D6 configurations, based on strength of ligand, there is a possibility of pairing of electrons. So to avail vacant d orbitals during, in case of D4, D5, D6 configurations, definitely the pairing of electrons are possible based on the strength of the approaching ligand. In such cases, there is a possibility of change in magnetic behavior when the central metal atom present in free ion form and after formation of its related coordination complexes. So let us have some examples to explain this. Fe F6 hexafluoroferrate -4 hexafluoroferrate. So in this hexafluoroferrate, the number of unpaired electrons are only one unpaired electron. But when it is going to form hexacyanoferrate -4, the number of unpaired electrons are changed from different from above condition. So this indicates the ligand strength also decides the number of empty or lone electrons or single electrons remains at central metal atom or ion after formation of metal complexes. As per our previous case, the magnetic momentum by using single electron method or simple method will be calculated by using N into N plus 2 formula, where N is equals to number of single or unpaired electrons present with metal atom or metal ion. So this is what we can expect. Once again, the expected application question from this topic is Mn Br 4 minus 2. The magnetic momentum of this is 5.9 boromagnetons. The question will be expected as the spin only magnetic momentum. This is the formula, spin only magnetic momentum. We can calculate spin only magnetic momentum of any metal ion or metal species. Mu is equals to square root of N into N plus 2 Bohr magnetons. Here the given metal complex, that is MnBr4 minus 2, having 5.9 boromagnetons of magnetic momentum, then they identify as predict the geometry of the complex. So this will be the expected question. Actually, mu is equals to 5.9 boromagnetons indicates manganese must be with 5 lone electrons or single or unpaired electrons. That means to show 5.9 boromagnetons of magnetic momentum, the manganese must be with 5 unpaired electrons. Let us consider manganese. The oxidation state of manganese in this complex is +2. So what is the atomic number of simple manganese? 25. And the valency shell electron configuration 3d5 4s 2. But when manganese available in Mn+2, it have to eliminate 2 electrons. Those 2 electrons are eliminated from s orbital, hence the resulting electron configuration will be 3d5 4s 0. Now 4p empty orbitals are present, while 4 bromide ions are approaching towards this 1 s orbital and 3 p orbitals are participates in hybridization, hence it is sp3 hybridization. So it shows sp3 hybridization outer orbital complex. There is no reorganization or pairing of electrons takes place in the presence of bromide ions or bromide ligand, due to which sp3 hybridization expected at manganese. Due to sp3 hybridization, it shows tetrahedral geometry. So this is what the conclusion we have to provide at the time of examination. So MnB4Br4-2 metal complex, tetraboromanganese 2 complex with 5.9 boromagneton, then we can predict the geometry. The two possible geometries are, one is tetrahedral geometry, one is square planar geometry, because of it is a tetra or 4 coordinate system. So the 4 coordinate complex molecule shows only 2 types of geometry, either tetrahedral or square planar. We have to predict which is that, tetrahedral or square planar. Outer orbital complexes with sp3 hybridization, tetrahedral geometry. Inner sphere or inner orbital complexes with dsp2 hybridization with square planar geometry. So this is here, due to presence of 5 unpaired electrons, it shows sp3 hybridization and exhibit tetrahedral geometry. So this is about valency bond theory. So valency bond theory is most important to explain magnetic character of the metal complexes. Let us have limitations of valency bond theory. Limitations of valency bond theory. Here, of course, the apted and explained valency bond theory for the formation of coordination complexes will have some drawbacks or limitations. Let us have what are the drawbacks we can identify with valency bond theory. So what is the first drawback? It does not explain